Namaskar everyone. It's actually been a while since I made a video of me talking to you guys. I hope I have not lost touch, because if you see my videos now, it's very easy for me. I just simply sit and I ask three basic questions. Can you talk about yourself? Can you tell how you found Sadhguru and how inner engineering happened? And then if you look at all my videos, these are the two basic questions I ask, but each of the interview videos is totally different. Because the kind of experience that each person goes through and the way he articulates it is so different that no two video looks the same. So in today's video, this is something very special for me. It has been 1 year since I completed my inner engineering. It was in the month of May that I got initiated into Shambhavi Mahamudra, and after that life took a very transformational change. So I would like to talk about how this 1 year has been to me and what all other stuff that has happened in a nutshell. I hope I stop the video, I make the video small. But before inner engineering happened, how it happened is also important. I was going through a very tough phase, you know, and things were not going the way I wanted. I was having panic attacks after I got my MPhil admission. I was like, what the hell is happening? I had read many Sadhguru books, and one of the events that I still remember is that on one night when I was sleeping, actually Dhyanalinga came in my dream and some kind of energy hit me and I just woke up and I'm like, what the hell happened? I need to go there. At that time I did not know something like inner engineering or such a program existed. I thought, you know, I'll just go and sit in front of the Dhyanalinga and oh, I will get enlightened or something like that. So there I sent them a mail that you know, I actually sent an email to Isha Foundation saying that I want to come and visit, and you know what I wrote in the purpose? Dhyanalinga came in my dream and something like that I wrote. When I think back about it now, it it makes me smile. But actually I wrote that in the email, that I saw Dhyanalinga in my dream and I want to, you know, come and be there. So I got a reply, yeah, you come, there's a cottage, you book cottage. So I booked cottage, I went there, sat there, stayed there for 3 days. And there's so much limitations within me broke actually during those stay. I think, look, I had all these ideas of an ashram being, you know, people full time sitting, not doing anything and like that, but it is a totally different, you have to experience it for yourself. So I reached there, so I was very, you know, excited to be in the Dhyanalinga. So I went like, yes, something is going to happen like in the dream. But when I went inside and sat there, nothing actually happened. I just simply sat there. I could see people sitting still, closing their eyes, meditating, but for me, I was just simply sitting. But I did not give up. Every day there was a procedure, like a schedule. We are given a schedule which if you like we can follow. So I used to follow it every day. I used to take a dip in the Suryakund, go stay there, sit in the Dhyanalinga. One thing that I made sure was I switched off my mobile phone. I had told my parents and everyone that I won't be using phone, only I'll be switching it on once in a while and sending them a message saying that I'm okay and everything is fine. So this is what I did. I made sure I enjoyed the ambience. I was like, I need this stuff. Somehow I had to make it work. I need to get out of this nonsense that I was going through. So, and then even in the Bhiksha hall, it was the first time for me, you know, sitting on the ground and eating. I used it. I eat sitting on the ground, but this is like something special. It's the way the food is served, and after that we have to clean our plates. And even while cleaning the plates, you know, the tap was on and I was cleaning the plates, and suddenly this lady on the side like, what is this? Why are you wasting water? You should not waste water like this. I was taken aback. I'm like, why is she so rude to me? You know, I was in such a condition that even if someone talked a little bit, you know, raised their voice, I thought they were being mean to me. And I was like, when this lady talked to me like that, I was like, oh no, what is this happening? This is the ashram and people are still rude. This is not right. But now when I look back at it, it was good. What risk is in the ashram? If everyone starts, you know, just pouring so much water just for washing a plate, it will cause a lot of loss. And it is highly essential that everyone are strict. Now also when I go to the ashram, I do some kind of stupidity and someone tells me, no, this is not how the way you do it. And they say it very strictly. It's not that they are rude or they are angry or anything. They know that it needs to be done in, needs to be said in a certain way so that it... Because still I remember the way that lady told that now whenever I wash the plate, I make sure that I close the tap. So it worked. So even people are rude to me nowadays, but it's just that now it doesn't affect me. I know there's a purpose and the center has to work in a particular way so that it lasts. A process has been set up so that it has to last for, you know, decades. So now I understand. I think I understand. I'm not sure. I think I understand. That's why maybe Sadhguru has set it up like that. But I don't mind. I just go there for my own purpose. Yes. So where was I? Yes, in the ashram stay. So everything was peaceful. But when I came back home, again, you know, all this nonsense started coming up. And that's when one of my friends, Jayakrishnan, he's a Hatha Yoga teacher. He sent me this inner engineering program. And it was just like, you know, right now I'm shooting this video in my aunt's place. And here it happened, here just nearby to the place was just like what, 50 meters away, and I was taken. It's just like a walkable distance, not even 2 minutes for walking, then inner engineering was happening. So I registered for it and went over there, and I did not have much expectations. I did not know what the program is. I actually had no idea. I had not done any kind of yoga or meditation much in my life. When I was a kid, I did it, yoga, and I totally hated it. It was twisting and turning and, you know, pouring water from the nose, drinking a whole lot of water and vomiting. It's so many stuff I had to go through, and I hated yoga. I thought yoga is nonsense. But still, I did not know what was being taught here. And when I went through the 7 days, I realized what yoga is, how powerful it is, and it is not twisting and turning the body into, like Sadhguru says, a leftover noodle. It is not that. It is actually a tool for the ultimate, and it is something so beautiful that I realize life within me opened up. I had a lot of philosophies, I had read a self-help books, I had so much nonsense, even spirituality, I had read so much books that, but when it actually touched me, I realized that it's becoming nothing. It's becoming less and less of myself and being more and more open to life around me. And after that, the importance that I place for myself in my life drastically reduced. After that, it has all been for me to, you know, make this reach out to others. I had big goals and ambitions, like I need to be famous, I need to be that. But after that, that all I left. I did not have any goals or ambitions. I was like, whatever I can do to make inner engineering happen, that I will do. Whether it's local volunteering, I'll do that. Whatever it is, I'll do. So that's how I started volunteering. And even YouTube, this YouTube videos, I was not giving it any importance. I was like, leave it. This needs to happen. But like Sadhguru says, when you become very, very ordinary, you become extraordinary. Like this is what I had stopped giving too much importance to me, stopped too much giving too much importance to what I wanted to become and all that stuff. And I started focusing on what I could do right now in this moment. I started focusing on day to day steps that I could do to make it happen for others. And when that happened, I think I just became more open to grace. This is what Sadhguru says about grace. Like grace is like a lubricant in your life. Even if you have a very fast, like a super machine, like a Ferrari, if you do not lubricate it, it won't even, you know, travel for a kilometer before it breaks down. Similarly, if you look around, most people nowadays, they talk about hard work, work hard, do this, do that, and still they are miserable, sad, and everything. But if you have a certain amount of grace in your life, you will move through life very effortlessly. See, when people ask me, I still get emails like, Vaishak, you're doing so much hard work. You are doing some, are you able to do this? I say, hard work? No, I am not doing any kind of hard work. I am just chilling around. I am doing nothing actually. It's just that maybe around me people, I am like the videos and all, they feel I am doing a lot of work, but I am just riding the grace. I am just riding Sadhguru's wave. You know, whatever happens or doesn't happen according to my desire, I am like, it's fine, it didn't happen, no issues. What will I do next? So I know whatever plans or ideas that I can make, those are very constipated goals, like Sadhguru says. If you actually achieve your goal in your lifetime, you have a very constipated goal. So have a vision, have such a vision in your life that, you know, you are sure that you will die unsuccessfully. So I am still in that search, you know. I think that is there. Like my wish is that everyone gets inner engineered all around the world, and this touches everyone. I think that's definitely not gonna be possible, but I'll try. Right now, I have my constraints. I just have so much equipment, so much money, and so much time to do this stuff. But if my capabilities, my caliber increases, I'll do more work. So right now, what I can do, I do, and it's going beautifully. even when, like I said, I did not give much importance to my YouTube videos. Like I was having, like even putting out a video was becoming tough for me before, but after inner engineering it just became effortless. Even I stopped editing my videos, I just put it out like that. But things have started working. If anyone looks at it, how the hell is this video working? I do not even edit it. I just simply sit and talk. There is no graphics, not much background music. It is just me talking about my experience. One normal, you know, nonsense guy talking about his experience. How can this touch lives? But like Sadhguru says, if you're actually doing the right thing, things will happen. And I think I am doing the right thing because this needs to happen right now in the world. And that's why it's connecting with a lot of you guys, and you are able to relate with that. And it's so, so beautiful. Like after inner engineering, once I was in the railway station in Coimbatore, there was this thing written around. It's not about being a superhuman being. It's to understand that being human is super. And I really understood it. Like recently the Avengers movie released. So I was going through the movie. So from my childhood, I had all this thing that I want to be, I had to have some superpowers. I want to be like Spider-Man. Or when I saw the Iron Man suit, I'm like, shit, give me an Iron Man suit. But now after all this process, when I watch after inner engineering and all the process, when I'm watching Avengers, I'm like, when I'm seeing these superheroes, I'm like, what's the big deal about this? There's no use of all this, because I know what I have got now is that is far, far more beautiful than the powers of all those superheroes combined. Because I just realized that, you know, this body, this mind body, this is the ultimate tool. And if we actually have the user's manual to make it work the way we want, beautiful things can happen. And it is just so beautiful. And whenever you know, there are, it's not that I don't have, I hope this locket didn't make sound this time. I'll just remove it. Yeah, this is the Devi locket. Okay, I hope it didn't make a sound, click click sound. Yeah, so it's not that I don't face doubts or you know, whether what I'm doing is actually, but every day, you know, I get so many emails from people on how my videos touch them, and you know, how it has helped them out, and how it has made them access to inner engineering, and how inner engineering has touched their life. That is the main thing. It's more than my videos. I know my videos are just like a vessel. Like these videos are of no consequence if you actually do not have something to take an action. So in my videos, it's not, I make sure it's not about talking about spirituality or, you know, talking about all this stuff that like I used to do before. But it's actually to make sure that each one of you guys have an access to take at least one right step in it. And whether it's through the Sadhguru app using Isha Kriya, or helping you find a center near you, or telling you the details about how to reach the ashram, or how to book a cottage, each of these activities is so, so important to me. Because when I was there, I didn't find I had to do it all alone. Like when I went to the ashram, I didn't know there was such a program known as inner engineering, like so back. So but it was due to one volunteer, my friend, who sent me that I realized it. It's due to the work of so many volunteers in order to prepare the poster, in order to set up the whole, that inner engineering happened to me. So I am trying to make that more accessible to all of you guys, because I know I have to reach where you guys are. And right now our generation, everyone are in YouTube, Instagram, Twitter, LinkedIn. And if you look at it, even Sadhguru is everywhere, because he's a mystic of the times, and he knows he has to reach out to people where they are. And it's so beautiful. Like Sadhguru is someone, he need not do any of this. He can actually simply close his eyes and just sit there like that in ultimate bliss. But he does it. So why should I not do it? I also do it because I know this needs to reach people. Like once if they are touched, something so beautiful happens to them. Because most people I see, they are struggling in their life, so much struggle, whether it's their career, relationship, family, they're struggling for everything. Almost humans have made everything into a suffering. There is like very less moments of happiness. If you ask people, today how many times were you happy, they're like, today in 1 month I was like one time happy. I think that also I had to go party somewhere, travel a lot, spend a lot of money. It's very rarely that a person can simply sit, close his eyes, and you know, tears of joy can come out of his eyes just by observing a tree or a flower or seeing a kid smile. People have lost it. So the whole idea is to bring that back. Why wouldn't you want to live happily? Hey, wouldn't everyone want to live happily? See, there's this one thing that I see in Sadhguru's videos. He'll be sitting in a group of people in a satsang. He'll ask people, what kind of people do you want to be around? Joyful or miserable? So everyone will answer, joyful, Sadhguru, of course, joyful. Then Sadhguru looks at them, smiles and says, see, everyone around you also wants the same. And that's so beautiful. See, we all of us, even me, I want to be around joyful and happy people. So won't people around me also want to be around joyful and happy people? So isn't it highly essential that I make myself into a joyful and happy person? Yes, it is highly essential. Each one of you, if you actually care for, you know, people around you, humanity, society, or whatever is important to you, first you make yourself a happy and joyful person. It's not, I'm not saying passing laws is not important, or working in NGOs or starting movements. This is all very important. But you can only do this, you can only enjoy all of this process if you're first a joyful and a happy human being. If you are miserable and you start all of these things, trust me on this, you will create far, far more misery and hatred in the world than help. You can look at it, like most of the nonsense that is going around is done by people who think they are, you know, they are doing some kind of great things in this world. I think the Game of Thrones is a good example of it. The Khaleesi, she thinks she is doing a great favor for the world, but spoiler alert, don't watch it if you have not watched Game of Thrones. But what does she do? She kills everyone in the name of what? In the name of freedom and like that. So you see, she thinks she is doing the right thing, but in the end, what the hell is she doing? So don't be like that. Don't be a Khaleesi. Be like Jon Snow. Yes, be like Jon Snow. Do what is required right now in the moment. Now I know a lot of people didn't like Jon Snow killing Khaleesi. But at that moment, even though he loved her, he killed her. Because at that moment it needed to be done. And he was the only one who could do it. Great, I think I really loved Game of Thrones. I hope the mic is not off. Yeah. Because that's superb. I know a lot of people hate it, but I just loved it. I think the whole Game of Thrones series was totally to give you the unpredictable stuff. But I think right now everyone wants what they want to come out in the movie, I mean in the series. But I really liked it and the way it ended, and it was totally cool for me. This is just my opinion and this thing. So, oh, from where we started, from Inner Engineering to Game of Thrones. I am definitely not a spiritual person, I think. So, yeah, that's about it. So, guys, reach out to me if you want any kind of help to make Inner Engineering or anything, or you want to talk about something, definitely reach out to me. I'm there on Facebook, Instagram, everywhere. It's all there in the description. We also have a very good Facebook group called Inner Engineering, unofficial page by volunteers. It's a very open group, very free. You can talk about your experiences, whether it's regarding inner engineering or something else, you can put out, and it's totally cool. That's why I've created that group, so that, you know, there's a community where all of us can be together, and it's hard to, you know, find people around. So that's why a community, online community, has been created. So definitely make use of it. Do check out my other videos. There's this interview series videos and a lot of interviews in that, and there's the Yogi Ray series, question answer sessions with Mukul Anna. I'll be doing a lot of more interviews soon. So guys, it's been great. It's been great coming back and, you know, doing a video like this, because I'm getting a lot of interviews nowadays. So it's most of the time I'm posting that. I'll be doing more of such videos. All the love, guys. I hope you make this happen for yourself. Like Sadhguru says, a world full of love, light and laughter. Its time has come right now. Let's make it happen. Namaskar.